Time for entertainment news at midday. Adam and Raven profess their love right after last season's Bachelor in Paradise.
Raven, you love this man.
Yeah.
I love you too.
Oh, you're so cute.
Now it's a year later and they're still going strong and even living together. So are they ready to write their forever love story? Well, that's why we have them in studio. We've got Adam Gottschalk and Raven Gates, and we're inviting you to midday. Thank you so much for joining us, guys.
Thank you for having us.
Okay, so you have to kind of let us know, what's it really like in paradise?
Very hot.
And humid.
And humid.
But what about the details?
No
is it
AC.
All just, you know, what is it? That you make it seem like it's lust and kissing and drinks and just, is it like that,
yeah,
what you see on TV?
It's pretty accurate. What
okay.
you see on TV,
yeah,
is pretty accurate.
It's pretty spot on.
Yeah.
With the makeout sessions, the parties, a lot of that. But, you know, yes, in that kind of environment, a lot of people don't think that you can really find love, but
right,
you guys did.
Yeah.
Tell us more about your love story.
Take the reins, girl.
Go ahead, Raven, you got it.
I just knew that Adam was a really great guy, and that's what I was coming to Paradise for, and not for anything else, but to find a guy and lock him down. And I knew Adam was such a good catch that I better not mess it up. And
aww,
so, yeah, that's how it kind of worked out. And Adam, you know,
before,
felt the same way,
like,
apparently.
Yeah, Adam, so, you know, how did you feel about Raven when you first met her? In this scenario where it's kind of, you know, I mean, you're just meeting somebody for the first time, what stood out about her?
I think a lot of it, there was a lot of mysteriousness behind Raven, and it was one of those things you really had to kind of peel back her layers and figure out, you know, more about her. And I had interest and I was intrigued by her at first, but I think what's so much different about Paradise compared to the Bachelor or Bachelorette is that you just spend so much time with one another. And I was explaining last time I was on the Daybreak that I maybe spend a total of maybe 8 or 9 hours with Rachel when I was on the season. And you got to keep in mind, we were with each other all day, every day. So if you're not on a date,
nice,
you're on the beach hanging out, you're in the pool.
Yeah, we're always
you're
there.
Like, you're starting to talk, your conversations are becoming deeper about
each other. Oh, that's sweet. I like that. And so you are a local guy.
Yeah.
Originally from Dallas, right?
No, I'm originally from LA, but I've been living here
Dallas
for close to 7 years.
Okay, you're from Dallas now.
Yeah,
okay,
pretty much.
We're claiming you.
Yeah.
We're claiming you, and you're originally from
Arkansas.
Okay, mm-hmm. I was gonna say that those Dallas guys have that charm, but I don't know those fast talking LA
this charm here still.
I'm not sure. Okay, well, you know, you returned to Mexico last night. You guys are busy on the go, but
yes,
you went to kind of give someone some advice. Would
yeah
you tell us about that?
Well, it was pretty interesting because when I walked into Paradise, I thought, after I had talked to Tia before she left for Paradise, that she was going to kind of expand her thoughts on maybe finding someone else besides Colton.
Oh, you don't like him.
And I just, I thought if it doesn't work out at first, it can't work out again. Like,
yeah,
my mom says, never chew your cabbage twice.
Ooh.
Don't go back and do something you've already done. You
I
know
like
what
that.
I mean?
What do you think about it, Adam?
I agree.
Yeah.
And Raven, like, she laid down the hammer. And I think that's what makes her so special. She's just so raw and unedited, and it's like people respect that more than anything. Rather than like saying, oh, you know, you should think twice about it. It's like, no, these are the red flags.
And you're not just going to subject your friend to some drama just for ratings on a show.
Yeah.
I mean, you really care about her feelings, and you're worried that Colton might hurt hers.
Of course. And I hope, you know, this show's not over yet, and I hope that Colton proves me wrong. So that's all I can hope for my friend, is to tell her the truth, and maybe Colton will prove me
wrong. We're not going to spoil anything there, but we're hoping that Tia is happy now.
Yeah,
okay,
of course.
Okay, excellent, excellent. So let's talk about you guys living out here in Dallas together. Raven, how long ago did you move out here?
A month ago.
Congratulations and welcome. Big
thank
Texas
you,
welcome
you
to you. Now, you guys have been living together. Did you find out some new things about each other now that you're kind of just, you know,
oh, yeah,
sharing rooms?
Yeah,
oh, yeah,
a lot.
Anybody got any kind of pet peeves working or anything?
Yeah, of course. You know, we're so different.
Uh-huh.
So I'm super messy. He is very put together, as you can see.
You're both put together.
Well, I am today.
Okay, okay. But you know what? Tell us about your outfit, though, because I understand you had a boutique in Arkansas.
Yes.
But some big news.
Yes. I'm looking at opening a location here in Dallas. So we will be in Arkansas, Dallas, and online.
Oh,
so,
girl, you're taking over the world here.
I'm
and I was
trying.
Loving this outfit right now.
Thank
this jumper
you
is hot. All right,
thank
Adam
you
likes it, too.
It's spicy.
It's spicy. That's
yeah
what we need there.
It's
and Adam, you have an interesting job.
Yes, I work in commercial real estate, a group called Strive here in Dallas, and mm-hmm we're probably one of the most premier investment sales firms in Texas, and we sell retail product all over really Texas.
And Adam is very good at his job.
I can tell he's very good because
very
off
good.
Camera, when you guys weren't here, you were telling me about Raven's outfit and kind of selling me on it. Yeah. So I'm getting those vibes from you for sure. But let me ask you this. Would you ever return to Paradise maybe for the future proposal, maybe wedding bells? I don't know.
I don't think there's any reason to go back.
I don't know, maybe, yeah. More TV time? I don't know, maybe.
I think we're
modeling more outfits.
It was great to be on TV then, but we found each other, so now it's just our personal families, personal lives together, and we're just focused on that instead of TV.
Okay, well, I can completely understand that. Welcome to Dallas. We hope
Thank
to see
you.
More of you guys. Thank you so much for joining us on the show. Be sure to watch Bachelor in Paradise Monday and Tuesday nights right here on Channel 8. Right now, we're sending it over to Kyle Roberts for another check of your Adam-approved forecast.